What's up, guys? Welcome back to Skip's Guns. So today we are going to be talking about Icarus Precision, and if I'm being honest, it's probably one of the best companies that I have ever worked with. I am honored to work with them, to speak with Travis and every single person that works there. I feel like I'm actually part of the family. So it is a family-run business. They pump out some amazing stuff. They started out where they were doing car parts, like high-end Ferrari stuff, I'm pretty sure. And a buddy of his actually said, hey, could you make me an aluminum grip for my P320 with a 1911 grip angle? And Travis took that, ran with it, and they created the full size, which was pretty much just an aluminum version of what the X5 Legion lower is, except it was the 1911 grip angle. Then they jumped over, they started making the other one. They had a couple little different designs that really fixed a lot of stuff, undercut trigger guards, stuff like that. And then the P365 started really taking off to where everybody wanted to modify it because it was a great little carry gun. P320s are awesome, but let's be honest, the 365 is probably the better of the two. So the 365 started its life like this. You have a little 10-round mag. You have a proprietary rail that literally just sucks. But the gun itself is pretty awesome when you really think about it. I mean, look at how small this guy is. It conceals beautifully. It shoots awesome, except it is a little snappy. So this is a bone stock version. We are empty. You have a lot of creep there. A lot of take up, I guess. No creep. Well, a little creep. And then a crisp break. And then the reset is a little long, but it's there. So with this thing being as snappy as it was, Travis really dove in and tried to fix this whole thing. So what he originally did was the game changer. Took the front and put a Picatinny rail on it. Now you could actually put lights on the front of it. And then he gave you some contact points right around here, a little texturized version. And it pretty much stopped there for that first model. It was a big hit. It really does change the characteristics of the gun. You lose a lot of the snappiness, but there could still be more. So he did the same rail, jumped into an undercut on the trigger guard. He changed a little bit of the texturing and gave you a different beaver tail that really helps you grab the gun from concealment. And then the game changer was putting on a little ledge on the side to be able to put your thumb on to mitigate recoil. And then it really started exploding. Parker Mount Machine Works at the same time started making the compensator for the X model, where it would make it the XL length, but it would give you a compensator on your X version, or like this, just the normal version. And from there, they teamed up and they made this, which is honestly one of the best lowers I have ever experienced. When I first got one of these, I was like, this is the answer. So you have the Picatinny rail, now you have ambi thumb ledges, then you have the undercut trigger guard, an aggressive texture that's not going to rip you up, it's just giving you texture. You have a base plate that matches and sits in there nicely. Then you have a half of a magwell here that's great for the back of your palm. It really fits the hand so much better. Then you have an exaggerated memory bump, and you have that whale tail, as I like to call it. And this thing was awesome because once you take this slide and put the Parker Mountain setup on it, it extends it out to the XL length, but it will sit flush on one of these. So that really was a game changer there. Then what they did was SIG actually tried to step up their game. They came out with the Macro. So the Macro is basically now having the Picatinny rail, you don't have it undercut, you can change the back straps. It's kind of got a little bit of a magwell. This thing's really nice though. It's definitely a good setup. And also you get an integrated compensation where the barrel is a 3.1 inch and then the slide is made for the 3.6 or 7 inch. I believe it's 6. So you get a lot of coolness in this. Well, Travis, again, being the person that he is, took that as a challenge and came out with probably the best lower he has done to date. And that is where we get this sick son of a gun. He took that lower, he gave it a bigger magwell, he changed up the texturing, you get an emphasized memory bump and then the exaggerated whale tail, you have all this texturing, added texture up here, ambi gas pedals, still sticking with the Picatinny rail, undercut trigger guard, and the 1911 grip angle. I mean, this is an all-out monster. I mean, these guns, they just shoot so different now with all of this stuff. And you might say, well, I mean, I paid $600 or something for this. Why would I want to throw in all the money to get to this? When you shoot it, you'll see exactly why. And with all of this stuff, it still actually conceals really well because the gun is so thin, and that's the point of these guns working so well in concealment. It could be huge with extensions and comps and all this crap on it, but it's still thin and it conceals so nicely that you can't even see that it's actually on your person. So with the macro, you get bumped up to 17 rounds, but Taran Tactical makes a universal magazine base plate that makes you hold 20 rounds. Then one in the chamber, you're at 21. I can do math. If you go with an SGZ trigger job, you get a phenomenal trigger. So here you get a lot less take up with a pretty crisp break. The reset, I mean, it is just night and day compared to what you get when you first get the gun. And here is a good example of that. So we are empty. There's the take up. There's the break. Reset. Break. And then I'll show you my carry gun. So here is the take up. A lot shorter, and then the break, reset. I mean, it definitely changes the game. So with Parker Mount Machine Works and Icarus Precision working together, you get this kind of beast. And this thing, it's perfect. There is nothing wrong with it. But of course, the guys that had the XL version wanted the same thing, and this is what they got. This is an XX macro lower. So this is a 365 XL slide with the Parker Mountain comp and barrel. And then you have the same kind of macro lower, but you could see it's flush with the bigger gun. So in comparison, you get that extra about, let's say half inch, and you get all of the awesomeness of the other gun, but it's a little bit bigger. And if you take this and you pair it with that Taran Tactical base plate, I mean, forget about it. And still that thin, so it completely conceals awesome. So from there, I'm not done. I know, it's pretty crazy. From there, they, Icarus started working with FDES Works, and they introduced me to them. Will is an awesome guy. I love the fact that everybody in this community really pulls together, and we all do some pretty amazing stuff. And that's when this came out. So this thing is a frigging work of art. This is one of my carry guns. And you see, the fire bronze coating is absolutely sick, but FDES does a pretty much taking the macro lower, which, like I showed you before, takes this and jumps it to a different level. So instead of it just sitting flush on the end, you have this little butler cut, and then it extends out, gives you a comp up front. And then you have some suppressor height blacked out sights, which is awesome. You get all of these windows and serrations that really just change the game of this gun. I mean, it is absolutely just beautiful. And then a direct mount cut that sits super low in there. This is actually not even the EPS carry. It is an EPS, and it's sitting on here great. Still co-witnesses. You get a full-size dot on a small-ass gun. And from here, now this is just a prototype. There is going to be no selling this, I'm pretty sure at least. This is actually comped and ported, as you can see. 1, 2, 3, 4 ports with a DPM recoil kit, an SGZ trigger job. This thing is a friggin' monster to shoot. And then it just looks gorgeous. So whether or not you want to go super flashy and integrated comp, or you wanted to go with just kind of let's get down to business and you want to go with the Parker Mountain comp, both of them shoot amazing. Or you wanted to go more full-size setup and then just toss this guy together. Or you want to go casual and use one of the Icarus Evo lowers, you really can't lose. You have so many options. People get really confused and hit me up in the comments all the time talking about, oh, I don't know which lower works on which one. It's first off, read the descriptions of any of those websites. It all says it. If Icarus goes and breaks every single thing down where it'll say what barrel, what comp, what slide, what this, what that is going to work with each one. So it really does explain it if you just read a little bit more. But I mean, just look at the difference here. They took something that looked like this and made this, and then from there turned it into this. I mean, which one would you guys pick? Because I'm gonna say I'd go with this. So guys, this was, I know, not a lot of or any shooting, but I am going to do a dedicated shooting Icarus video for you. I'm gonna shoot all of these guns, give you the actual difference of what they all shoot like now, as well as I think I'm going to add in changing the DPM recoil springs, because so many people ask me that, even though no matter how many times I make a video saying that your gun is going to shoot different than mine, so me telling you what springs I use doesn't really matter. I figure if I do it, you guys will kind of understand it a little more. Plus, you could just see the difference of these guns actually shooting, because I haven't really seen anyone do it. They haven't taken the OEM version, jump up to the macro, and then jump up to a friggin' FDES Icarus Precision Monster, or more so of a full-size setup. So hopefully you guys enjoy this. I tried to somehow manage getting all of these guns back together. I actually own this one again. Ron was looking to get rid of it. I bought it back because this is the one that kind of started all of this stuff. So I am super happy to have this guy back in the arsenal, because I actually did sell my Parker Mountain setup that was built like this, and I really did like it. So this guy's back in action, and obviously we're still going to go with this SIG Viper. So if you guys are interested, check out the next video. It will be Icarus Precision the entire way, but a whole lot more shooting. And we'll test out the DPM recoil springs, since that seems to be the most important thing in your guys' heads right now. But do know this, if you want to keep your gun oiled and cleaned, Goliath Gun Care, down in the description is a coupon code for you, as well as the link to their site. And any ammo we shoot in videos these days is going to be Nautilus Ammunition, amazing stuff. Also, a discount code down in the description as well. And Patreon. You guys have noticed you haven't seen any ads throughout this entire video. That's because I do not monetize. I make zero money off of YouTube. This is more to help you guys and then build up SGZ as a whole, because this is actually a business. I do this for a living, all right? So I take these things and I make them as awesome as they can be so you guys can enjoy them. So if you could, I would really appreciate it. Could be $5 donations, but any money that I get from there is going to go right back into the channel, getting me more stuff like this and giving you guys more information on what kind of builds you want to do in the future. So guys, I hope that you have a wonderful night. This is amazing to be a part of this entire Skips Guns world. Thank you to everybody. Remember this, stay safe, believe and achieve, and we'll check you later.